For today's video, I'll speak about Patrick Cripps and Sam Walsh, who played last night in the AAMI Community Series. I'll just speak about them as Supercoach picks and whether my thoughts have changed or not. But one thing I will say is before I speak about those two players is I constantly see on Twitter and wherever that in the preseason, don't worry about your premiums, just worry about mid-prices and rookies because, you know, premiums are premiums. It's just a practice game. While I think there is some merit to that point, I also think that every player, I would like to watch every single player, I just want to make sure they're fit. But every player for me is case by case. So it's not just, you know, this premium, XYZ premium, it's the premiums are, there's different circumstances for each premium. So for example, Dustin Martin's done it for years. If he scores 50, I don't care. If Rory Laird scores 70, I don't care. Tom Stewart scores 70, I don't care, as long as they're fit. But Cripps and Walsh, they have this criticism against them, and they are not 600k midfielders for a reason. So it is a small sample size, but I needed a little bit more convincing because, you know, why is Cripps only 530k? Well, his 30 game average is about 100. So ever since mid 2019, he just hasn't been that top echelon for Supercoach pick. And Sam Walsh, well, he's never been an uber premium in Supercoach. He's had one good half of a year in a coronavirus season, in a weird season, and that's all we're going off. So I saw, watching them play, I saw their deficiencies and the reasons why they're not 600k. So Patrick Cripps, is he actually good anymore? Is he all Australian caliber player anymore? I haven't seen it for 30 games, and I understand he's had injuries and stuff, but it feels like his body has somewhat broken down over the past year and a half. Picked up a few injuries here and there, you know, limited preseason as well. Just because he was that good that long ago doesn't mean he's still going to be that good. So I get why you wouldn't be worried about Patrick Cripps. Maybe he wasn't, you know, it was a preseason game, he was just chilling up forward for a fair bit. For me, it was concerning because I need to see something that he is that player that he was. And I haven't seen that for a long time now. So for me, I have no interest in Patrick Cripps anymore. Am I overreacting? Maybe. You know, obviously the people that say, oh, it's just a preseason game, don't worry about it, you know, they're not worried, and I get that. But for me, because Cripps has had issues over the past year and a half, I needed to see something. So I'm not touching Cripps, I'm sorry. And, you know, who's to say his body won't slow down again as it has the past two seasons? So that's my thoughts on Cripps. And Sam Walsh, I liked his work in the preseason a lot. We've seen them more inside mid-time, which is great. Spent a bit of time on the wing, but the game was really long. I think he had over 24 CBAs or something, so that was really encouraging. I thought he'd put on more size than he had. Looked not skinny, but not as big as some of the other guys out there, like compared to Steele. Steele was just much bigger than him. But with Walsh, it's what we saw from Walsh is some of the doubts that I've had over him as a Supercoach pick, and that's his disposal. Disposal was really terrible, and, you know, St Kilda are a really good team. They're going to pressure. They would have pressured Carlton. They're not an easy team to score against, the Saints. So if it was an easy team, it could have been very different. But I still don't mind Walsh. I am just worried that, you know, we haven't seen him as a premium for a full season. And last year, he had a really, really bad form slump at the start of the year. Like, absolutely terrible. And stormed home after the first six or seven games. So again, with Walsh, what I saw is there could be games because of his disposal. He fixed it up a little bit last year, but not all the time. He's still not a really great user of the ball. But what we saw is we could see games where he scores 115, 120 in Dream Team, and then he goes like 70 in Supercoach. You know, he was, I think, 85 Dream Team, 60 Supercoach last night, which is, it's not great. And, you know, it's hard because he's competing with a lot of the 600k mids are unbelievable, and I think it's okay to have one M8 that's, you know, not in that top bracket, but, you know, M7, he's kind of pushing it a little bit because you save money at the start of the year. You get some advantage from that, but I think the point still stands with Sam Walsh and Cripps. It's that the reasons why they're not 600k players we saw in the preseason game. Walsh's disposal, but he had the CBAs, which was great. And Cripps, well, is he actually that All-Australian player anymore? So it's hard to tell. It's only a preseason game. But at the same time, I wanted to be, I needed a little bit more convincing, and we're dealing with a small sample size because it's all we got. And of course we'd love a bigger sample size, but again, what are we supposed to do? So that's my thoughts on that. So I have more questions than answers watching those two play. But yeah, let me know if you're still picking Cripps or Walsh. For me, Walsh, maybe, I'm not sure. Cripps, I needed to see him in that form, and if I don't see it, then I'm not really interested, to be honest, but could be very wrong, but we'll see how we go. So thanks for watching the video, and we'll see you soon.